football Americans are underprepared or completely unprepared for a disaster or an emergency, such as natural disasters, technological and accidental hazards, terrorist attacks, or pandemics. In addition, more than half of Americans have not prepared copies of important documents such as Social Security cards or birth certificates. Copies of these documents should be kept in an emergency kit and saved electronically, whereas original documents should be put away in a safety deposit box. 42% of cell phone owners do not know important phone numbers. It is important to have hard copies of family members, doctors, fire and police departments, and poison control phone numbers in an emergency kit. More than half of parents do not have a designated meeting place in case of a disaster. Having a pre-planned meeting place will make it easier to reunite if other forms of communication are not possible. 48% of Americans lack emergency supplies. Having a kit is essential in case you are the only one able to provide for yourself and immediate others. A basic kit should include water, non-perishable food, a can opener, batteries, a radio, a flashlight, a first aid kit, a whistle, a mask, duct tape, sanitation supplies, tools, maps, and an emergency cell phone.
According to the Federal Emergency Management Agency, there are 6 steps in the planning process for emergency preparedness.
Step 1. Form a collaborative planning team on the community or individual level. This entails identifying who is in your team, including first responders, emergency managers, and public health practitioners, forming a common framework among team members, defining and assigning roles and responsibilities, and determining a regular schedule of meetings.
Step 2. Understand the situation. It is important to identify the threats and hazards, then assess your risk, and then prioritize your threats and hazards. Step 3. Determine goals and objectives. It is important to develop goals, which are general statements that indicate the desired outcome in response to an emergency. It is also important to develop objectives, which are specific actions necessary to achieve the set goals.
Step 4 in the plan is called plan development. In this step, you identify courses of action to take in the event of an emergency. Courses of action address what actions are needed, who is responsible for the action, when does or will the action take place, how long is the amount of time available to respond to the emergency, what happened before and what will happen after the emergency, what resources are needed, and how will the course of action affect specific populations of people. Plan development can also simply involve putting together an emergency stockpile kit, creating crisis communication and meeting plans, or simply obtaining emergency contact telephone numbers in case you need help.
Step 5, plan preparation, review, and approval. Format, write, and review the plan. Approve and share the plan with whoever is involved. Step 6, plan implementation and maintenance. Train stakeholders, exercise the plan, review, revise, and maintain the plan.
People need to plan for the worst so that even in the least likely of cases that something bad happens, they will be prepared.
Plans can be tailored to each individual. There is no set way. There are plans for families, college students, pet owners, and so on and so forth. Any kind of situation has guidelines to making a plan to fit certain needs.
It is the responsibility of community agencies to formulate and practice emergency preparedness because if something bad happens, the community is going to look to the authorities and the professionals for action and guidance.
Emergency preparedness is a twofold process. On the one hand, it is very important that there is a practice plan in place by the responders to ensure community safety in the most organized fashion. On the other hand, each individual should also have a plan, so if something bad were to happen, they know that their loved ones and themselves will be safe.
The following video is a humorous ad offered by the Ready Campaign and the Ad Council that addresses the lack of family emergency preparedness. However, it is important to avoid finding yourself in their situation should an emergency arise.
So who's going to do what?
I'll pack the dead batteries.
Great.
I'll only put what I don't need into a duffel bag.
Perfect. That's totally unhelpful.
No problem.
Meanwhile, I will try to comfort everyone by speaking in a calm voice.
And who is going to handle supplies?
I can forget to do a list for us.
Thanks, pal.
We couldn't be any less prepared. I'm proud of you guys.
When it comes to emergency preparedness, you should know the basics. Get informed about the different types of hazards that may occur in your area and learn how to address them. Most importantly, develop a plan. This will help you prepare for any emergency that arises. Assemble an emergency supply kit. Learn where to seek shelter if your home is not safe. Identify a meeting place and evacuation route. And finally, practice and maintain your emergency plan and supply kit so that you can remain calm when handling an emergency situation.